I'm PBJ, and welcome to Outdoor School from Home. We're here at Cook Park, which is on the native homeland of the Kalapuya Indigenous people. Today, we're learning about succession, so let's grab our journals and go explore. Have you ever wondered what happens in our forest after natural disasters like wildfires or volcanic eruptions like the one at Mount St. Helens? Come with me and let's figure it out. When the environment is changed by an outside force, it's called disturbance. What are some examples of disturbance that you can think of? Take 30 seconds to write down as many examples of disturbance in a forest as you can think. Welcome back. Well, what'd you come up with? Did you get flood or fire? What about volcanic eruptions or tornadoes? Could humans be a disturbance? I think we are. Anytime a habitat is changed by an outside force, it's disturbance. Can a habitat come back from a disturbance? Look out your window. What do you think your neighborhood will look like if we all just left to a distant planet right now? What would it look like in 10 years, 50 years, 100 years? Succession is the process in which a habitat recovers from a disturbance. It can take months, years, or even decades, depending on the disturbance. We're gonna explore this park to find all the different stages of succession, almost like we're traveling time. Let's look at the first or primary stage of succession. The first plants to come back from a disturbance are called pioneer plants. This is going to be things like grasses, flowers, and sedges. Their job is to help put nutrients back in the soil and help it retain moisture. Can you think of any pioneer plants in your area? Even now, primary succession is happening all around you. Now that the pioneer plants have started getting the soil healthy, we move to the secondary stage of succession. So this is going to be like shrubs and bushes. They also provide nutrients to the soil as well as cooling the soil, and that makes way for beneficial critters to move on in. Now that we have nice, healthy soil, we move into the intermediate stage. Depending on the environment, this is where trees start to grow. Here in Western Oregon, we get more deciduous trees to start, and if there are any around, coniferous trees will follow shortly after. Can anyone tell me the difference between a deciduous and a coniferous tree? Nice! You're right. Deciduous trees have leaves and coniferous trees have cones. Decades and centuries into the future, we reach the final stage of succession, the climax community. This is where we get enormous conifer trees shading out shorter deciduous trees. Old growth forests like Oxbow Park and the Redwoods are great examples of climax communities. Even the forest moon of Endor. Then, at some point, there's another disturbance and the whole process starts over again. Let's go back to thinking about what Earth would look like if we've left it for some other planet. Draw in your journals what you think your neighborhood would look like 200 years from now if there wasn't any human disturbance. Okay, let's review what we've learned so far. Primary with pioneer plants like grasses, flowers, and sedges. Secondary with shrubs and bushes, intermediate with smaller trees, and finally climax community with the largest trees. Thanks for joining me today. I hope you had fun and learned something along the way. If you want to check out more about succession, you can check the links on the asynchronous page. Have a good day and stay curious.